4-year-old boy is in serious condition at Kosair Children's Hospital after nearly drowning yesterday at Atlantis Water Park in Clarksville. Now some parents are saying lifeguards at the park were not prepared. Eric King is live in the newsroom with a look at those complaints and has a response from the water park. Eric?
Well, Rick, the water park is very quick to defend not only itself, but also its lifeguards. But at the same time, it admits there were some shortcomings. Sunday afternoon, a 4-year-old boy disappears under the waves at the Atlantis Water Park.
I'm not accusing anyone or saying anything, but what I witnessed and I saw was, I felt like an injustice was done.
Crystal Massey was there and saw the rescue firsthand, saying the little boy was spitting up water as the lifeguard pulled him from the wave pool.
The boy was laying basically on his back. The lifeguard was carrying him on his back. There was no sense of urgency whatsoever. The lifeguard was not running out. I noticed probably about 5 or 6 lifeguards around the area, and everyone was just kind of a shell-shocked look on their face. They were standing there just above trying to keep the guests back, but they were not the ones saving the child's life.
2 park visitors, one an EMT, the other a registered nurse, stepped in and provided medical treatment to the boy. On the scene, they told WLKY he had a light pulse. He was rushed to Kosair Children's Hospital.
Actually, I wasn't here yesterday, but yes, from what I hear, everything went straight to protocol.
Dan Boshi is the assistant manager at the water park and is quick to defend the actions of the certified lifeguards on staff.
Even though we may not have seemed like what we were doing was exactly right, we were following our protocol, and also we were trying to keep the situation as calm as possible.
While defending protocols, he concedes there were some shortcomings.
There was no resuscitation mask, or it also has the ability to be a BVM mask or bag valve mask. We did not have any of those or mouth protectors, unfortunately, but we have stepped up and I've made sure that everybody does have one now.
I can tell you that I will never go back to that park because I can never allow not only my safety, but especially the safety of my child to be there.
The park did reopen shortly after the incident and was back open today. No word, though, if there will be any type of investigation. Live in the newsroom, Eric King, WLKY News.
Thank you, Eric. Now, to work as a lifeguard in the state of Indiana, you must hold a lifeguard certification and be certified in first aid and CPR for the professional rescuer. The park says all of its lifeguards are current with their certifications.